Oh, it was such a rush. Just riding something so powerful. Getting whipped by the wind. Having your arms around the man of your dreams and holding on for dear life. It was so out there.
So in other words, you changed your mind about Bo's motorcycle.
No, I did not change my mind about Bo's motorcycle. It is definitely dangerous. Dangerously addictive. Oh, I hated that machine with every fiber of my being. I made it my mission in life to make sure that Bo got rid of that thing. And then one night, one ride, and I'm ready to get my own leather jacket. Wipe that smile off your face.
I'm just glad it worked out okay.
Yeah, you knew it would, didn't you? You were the one that convinced me to do it for Bo, and now I'm just so glad that I did it for me. Hey, you handsome. I was just extolling the virtues of motorcycle madness. You here to take me to lunch?
Both you and Georgie.
Oh, no, you don't have to do that.
Come on, a bet's a bet.
What bet?
The bike bet.
What bike bet?
Whether or not you would ride the motorcycle before the New Year's. See, I'd naturally bet that you wouldn't. Georgie, she swore up and down that you would. And I swear, honey, this is the best bet I've ever lost. And since the wager was a meal, I'm going to take you two lovely ladies to Rhodey's for double cheeseburgers, the works, whatever you want. Sky's the limit.
You're angry.
Nah, she's not angry. Are you? She is angry.
Why should I be angry? My husband, my legal assistant, make a bet about me behind my back. But it was just a joke, right?
That's exactly right, honey.
I'm just a joke.
No, that's not what I did.
And you manipulated me.
You wouldn't do anything that you didn't absolutely know that you wanted to do.
Oh, and next you're going to tell me that you know me better than I know myself?
Honey, look, this is all my fault. Don't put Georgie
on the spot. First you subvert her, and now you defend her?
But that was all my idea.
Oh, now you're defending him. I want an apology.
I will never, ever bet against you again, I swear.
Where's the apology in that? Did I hear, I'm sorry?
I'm sorry.
Not you, him first.
I'm sorry. But admit it. You loved it.
Nora, you're just the kind of free spirit motorcycles were meant for. I hated to see you deny yourself the pleasure. But it's not an excuse. Do you want me to resign?
First you make stupid bets behind my back, and now you want to make me miserable? Yeah, sure. Go right ahead and resign. Over my dead body.
Told you she wasn't really angry.
Yes, she is. She's very, very angry. But she's going to get over it. Because Georgie is invaluable.
What about me?
You own the bike.
And you can ride with me anytime you want.
Oh, well, in that case. But just remember, the end does not justify the means. I will not be outflanked by you guys again.
Okay. Now, can we eat lunch?
No, you know, really, this wasn't about the meal. I just wanted to make Nora happy. I mean it. I mean, it would just kill me if you thought that...
Okay. I forgive you. Honest.
Thank you. Now, you and Bo, go to lunch.
I can't. Chikara's coming.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
What, so I eat lunch alone?
No. Georgie won the bet. Georgie gets a cheeseburger.
No, that's okay.
Hey, a bet... is a bet.
But what if you need me?
I do, but only after my husband feeds you.
See, I never welch on a bet. It's a matter of principle.
No, he really doesn't, so go.
So we'll be at Rhodey's?
I know. Go.
We'll bring her back a double order of fries, double order of atomic chicken wings, okay?
Go. You know I'm gonna pay you guys back.
I'm not worried. You're the only person in the world that I know would never hurt me. I hope you feel the same about me.
I do, Georgie. Don't keep Bo waiting. He hates that.
Nora still surprises me.
Well, she's very complex.
Oh, yes, she is complex. She's exasperating. And she's wonderful. Frustrating.
Well, a good relationship takes a lot of hard work.
Mm-hmm. But it's worth it.
How did you and Nora meet?
What? It was a while back. This young lady named Marty Saybrook, she was pretty wild at the time, and she crashed a motorcycle right through the front window of the Banner. I know it probably sounds like motorcycles have been like this running theme through our relationship, but no. Anyway, Nora represented Marty. I was the only witness. So Nora had to do everything she possibly could to discredit my statement. But she ended up having to plea bargain. And she hated that I was right. You know? I don't know. To me, she was just much, much too intense. And she thought I was just much too laid back.
So it wasn't love at first sight?
No, not really. I think we probably proved that old adage, opposites attract. You know, but once there was a connection, then things just got better and better and better.
It must be so wonderful.
Well, George, you told me you've been in love before.
Oh, sure. Nora is so confident.
Yeah, you ought to see your sister, the psychiatrist. Yeah, the Hannon girls, they were brought up to believe that they could do anything. So, they can. They do.
Excuse me?
Oh, man. This looks great, Renee. Georgie, would you like another beer? This one's going a little flat.
Actually, can I get a seltzer with lime?
Sure. Yep,
absolutely.
All right.
Right back.
Thanks. The point of coming here wasn't to watch me eat.
You have such a healthy appetite.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I do.
But you keep so fit.
I'll tell you my secret. I have an incredible collection of old rock and roll records, tapes, everything. R&B. So what I do, I make my own tapes. And I put on these headsets and I just, you know, go to the gym, I sweat. Hey, you know what? Let's talk about you. I saw a marked improvement in your dancing abilities, Georgie, from that policeman's ball a couple of weeks ago to New Year's Eve. What's your secret?
I watched MTV and practiced.
Come on.
I'm really not that good yet.
No. I was impressed. I thought you were great. And so was Nora.
Okay, here you go. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Everything's perfect.
All right.